1966. I was only three.
You aren't as young, man.
And I went down to the induction center in Chicago with about four of my buddies. They all had their number came up the same month. And first thing they did was give you a physical. After the physical, I got in this line. I was behind this real tall guy with two heads. The guy in front of him was about 3'8", and he weighed about 600 pounds. All right, I'm in the right line. When I got up there, he told me that I passed. And go on to the next room because they wanted me to take an aptitude test so that I could be all that I could be. they didn't know, but I don't like checking tests, so I didn't open the question book at all. I just took the answer sheet, but ABCD, ABCD, and went through their machine that came out and said, "This kid's a fucking beast." So, he made me a head mechanic in a construction outfit. I didn't know my ass from my elbow. If it wasn't painted green, I couldn't fix it. I held a book in one hand and a wrench in the other. So they accepted me, even though they gave me this one sheet that gave you a choice of diseases. And I checked every one of them. I didn't know it, but 2 years later, when I went to get out of the Army, they brought that sheet of paper out. And they said, you still got that water on the knee? And I said, oh, no, that went away with the desert spell. They didn't want to have to pay for any of that. Onto an airplane. I'd never been on a plane before. And flew us down to Alexandria, Louisiana, put us on a school bus in the rain, drove us through the mud 60 miles to Fort Polk, Louisiana. Fort Polk, Louisiana was open in World War I, and then when the war was over, they condemned it as a fire trap. And they never tore it down, though, so when World War II came, they just reopened. And then closed it down after the war was over, reopened it for Korea, closed it down, reopened it for Vietnam. My guess is it's still open. It was a pretty terrible place. I didn't want to be there. I spent quite a bit of time there. And they had two little towns just outside the fort, if you were lucky enough to get a pass to go to town. One of the towns was called DeRitter, and that's where everybody went to church. And the other town was where nobody went to church. And that was Leesville. And we used to call it Diseaseville. And that's where I got the idea for the song.
I've been there.
Small town, bright lights, Saturday night. And balls and pearls are flashing their lights. Making change behind the counter in a penny arcade. Said the fast girl daughter of Virginia and Ray. Saturday afternoon, but dreaming just comes natural, like the first breath from a baby, like sunshine feeding daisies, like love hidden deep in your heart. Bunk beds, shaved heads, Saturday night, a warehouse of strangers with 60 white lights, staring through the ceiling, just wanting to be, they went up too many, a young PFC. Donald. And there were spaces between Donald and whatever he said, strangers forced him to live in his head. He envisioned the details of romantic scenes. Hot love, cold love, no love at all. A portrait of guilt is hung on the wall. Nothing is wrong, and nothing is right. Donald and Lydia made love that night. Sunshine.